In the 1950s, many Cook Islanders migrated to New Zealand to seek a better life for themselves and their families. Along with them, they brought their religious beliefs and their cultural roots. One particular aspect of their culture they brought was Uapou. Uapou is a religious practice of fellowship.
And it's with pleasure, with love, and with anticipation of a fantastic weekend, I declare the 2013 Uapou open!
Our people who brought it here, that's when the word Uapou came here to New Zealand. Uapou is the same word as fellowship. Fellowship is the interpretation of the word Uapou. Meaning if you say Uapou fellowship, you're saying the same thing. Uapou, Uapou, or fellowship, fellowship. Uapou is the coming of the people together. That's the real meaning of the word Uapou. It's fellowshipping together, coming together of the people. Here in New Zealand, it is a way of opening our culture out and the gospel be expressed through our songs, dance, and music. And that's, I think that's a good way to bring the people together.
In 1974, a delegation of leaders had assembled in Auckland to undertake church matters. It was at this gathering that an idea was sown and shared with the Cook Island leaders, and this was the introduction of the Uapou in New Zealand.
An approach from Papa Turubina. He called us, those delegation, to the assembly and said to us, we must meet. So we were meeting under a small tree in the Kaipa Pass Road. And said, I have a theme for us. E tumu mana ko mata takuite te mo mo mo. E ata au tumu mana ko wui te o rumito. He said, let us look at ourselves. Let us look at ourselves. So because he was in Hastings, he arranged that we meet the following year at Hastings. They will make all the plans. So we met in Hastings in a farmland of Tuki Tuki, they call it. And there was good representation of our orimitors and leaders from around Auckland, all over the place, to Wellington. So I think, fair to say, there were about almost 100. So we were listening. We were listening. Now, at the end of the day, they decided we were tossing what type of gathering we want to establish.
And the idea was to bring our people together. And the purpose behind it perhaps was also of religious purpose, to offer assistance to the trainees of ministry. That might be was the basis of their idea of establishing the Uapou.
I think that's when the Cook Island Uapou began, in 1975 in Hastings.
Today, the format of Uapou Fellowship runs through Queen's Birthday weekend. The event is attended by the Cook Islands Churches of New Zealand. Initially, the Uapou was set up to help finance Cook Islands people into ministry, but also a way to promote the Cook Island culture in a religious context. The wisdom of our leaders used the Uapou to promote three concepts. Firstly, they used the Uapou as a vehicle to reinforce the culture through customs and traditions played out through its songs, music, and dancers.
In the paper I wrote for the workshop, the two things that our people, our fathers or those people who traveled, migrated here, they brought their culture, their custom and traditions. Two things, the tradition and the custom, they are both different things. They brought with them to be their identity here, here as a Cook Islander. And to make those two things happen, so they found out the Uapou to be a tool to carry that identity out to the open. So when those things happen, when the Uapou happened, it brings those two, the tradition and the customs, together.
The second concept is identity. Identity of who one is comes from the adaptation of one's culture.
One of them was having the Uapou. In the Uapou, this is where you highlight your identity.
It's part of what makes the fabric or the fiber of a human being as a Kuki Airani, as a child created in that image. The dancing, the singing, the chants, the being part of all this, but it certainly is the build up. And it actually is pathways also to the growing of that child, the growing of the young ones too.
So singing and dancing our own cultures are a great way to express of who you are and showing what, how proud you are and the pride you have for your culture.
It's the biggest part of I feel about Uapou Fellowship. Identity, it's lovely, it's awesome how we can identify ourselves as Cook Islanders, especially New Zealand-born Cook Islanders. I'm definitely a New Zealand-born Cook Islander. For a lot of my life, I've always wanted to learn as much as I can of my culture.
And thirdly, the recognition and infusion of God as the number one facet of the Cook Islands people in Aotearoa, New Zealand.
I hope and pray that for our youth or our children will know that it's not just about our culture. The ultimate is to have that identity in Christ. That's the ultimate.
Therefore, the Uapou reinforces the customs and traditions of the Cook Island culture. It gives identity to who we are as Cook Islanders and enables us to give glory to God through the celebration of our culture. What then will maintain the future of the Uapou in the coming years? It is the experiences and impact we have on our young people that will determine the future of this wonderful event.
When like young youth see dancing and when they see singing, they're like, oh, that's cool, I can do that. And it's just like, it's like a little temptation of bringing them in. And then when they come here and they actually perform it, it's like, oh man, it's actually much bigger than just dancing and singing. It's actually sharing your culture with everyone else. And that's what brings everything together, brings everyone together, keeps us going.
Singing and dancing our own cultures are a great way to express of who you are and showing what, how proud you are and the pride you have for your culture. It's always a great way to get those connections towards God and get the connections towards your culture.
That's where we've got to celebrate what's unique in each community. We have a richness here in the Cook Island and Pacifica as well as Māori. And that's what we need to embrace and make sure that young people are connected to their kaupapa, to their culture, and use that as a strength and as something that they succeed in and use that success in the next part of their journey.
Any cultural aspects, eh, you know, and I'm meaning dance and performance and all those sort of things, they seem to, there's a huge correlation what we're finding between participation in that and educational achievement, educational engagement, eh? You know, all these sort of things, eh? That it's significant.
For my kids, I try and strong in sports, culture and education. If you've got those three things, then you can do anything.
Back in Hamilton, when we learn it, like the dance is like, okay, it's normal, just normal, traditional things. But when you come here and you dance in front of your own culture, you think, man, it's special because this is us. We do this, no one else.
E te o tāne, e te o wain,
the cultural revelation that youth experience at Uapou helps inspire and breed new leaders. Over the 3 days during Queen's Birthday, the young leaders are encouraged to compose the songs and dances for Saturday night, and also choir composition for Sunday. The older people take care of their dance performances and choir.
So in our Uapou, different people compose different things. The young people compose the young people's performance. Because if we do our way, it could be too old for the young people. young people will sit back and say, old-fashioned. But leave the performance to the young people because the young people performing.
The composers for each dance performance and choir composition must use the theme chosen for the weekend.
The host group, like if Tokoroa is hosting the Uapou, they will give out the verses for the people that come in, to all the ekaris here, to say, to tell them what is the version from the Bible they have to read and compose the song from it. Yeah, and the young people have this song, their version, and also the older people.
Tokoroa has many up-and-coming composers, and their inspiration has been developed and nurtured in their home churches through various leaders of both present and past.
I think practice is everything. The other thing is that it's about inspiration, who inspires you. And when Jesus is the ultimate inspiration, you can compose songs, drumming, whatever. We're lucky here where our metua allow us the freedom to compose drumming, to compose songs, and give us hints here and there. It's not always perfect when you first bring it out, but our metu are quick to correct and encourage us into our composition. So yep, it's not easy at all. In fact, we're really lucky here in Tokoroa to have so many who are gifted at composition, and they're always more than willing to share that talent with us. So we've been encouraged by many musicians, many drummers from the past who just help us to grow.
And so my wife, she's we make an awesome team. We really truly make an awesome team. And so my wife, she would sit day in, day out and listen to drum beats. She's got a lot of years stacked behind her of being a creative person on drumming, dancing, and I'm just a young boy on the corner. But I'm really grateful to be a part of the knowledge and wisdom that she's been given.
In Tokoroa, my mentors were people like Papa Taparia, Tuakana, Papa Ta, Upu Piri. I mean, we had some of the best writers of Cook Island music ever. Papa Ta, Taria, Whanaura, that was all through church too. Then we had people like Boy Simeona, Papa Toa, who was before my time, but the fruits of his labour filtered down through different people.
It's been awesome. I've played with some really, really awesome drummers here in Tokoroa, and some, names that they reign back in the Cook Islands, eh? And it's them that their teachings that have been passed down. And we've got a few drummers that have come to Uapou this year, has learnt the skill of drumming. Whereas all the other years, I've always thought that Uapou Fellowship was you bring your best guns and only they're allowed to drum. But it's nice to see fresh new drummers coming in, learning the art and the gift of drumming. Yes! Yeah,
The choir compositions from the young people and the elderly are composed into two main categories, the ute and the reo matua.
In simple translation, it's a love song. You can sing to, if you want, a woman, you sing through the ute. Although we have a different way of singing love songs to different people, or to your wife, to your, or you're serenading somebody. But the simple translation of the ute is a love song.
As for the ute, most of the ute are found. We sing different the ute differently from how the Tahitian does. When I was living with my grandparents in Tahiti, we used to go to the festivals in the July festival, the Bastille festival. Ute is part of the competitions they do. There's ute by a group that which the Cook Islanders do, and there's ute by one person, and there's a duet where a man and a woman will sing the ute and then the others will just support. So they sing differently from us. Us is a group thing. I was told that most of the ute come from the drinking. You know how we have our tumunu and we have our drinking area? That's where the ute outflows from. Maybe it came from French Polynesia, who knows? But that's why you will find a lot of ute got not sung in certain areas. The ute is sung like you have a tare, it goes, tere, tere. Then the group will go, aye. Then a leader will sing. For example, the one that's happening, Owe tauwe papa viriam ka pa te wa aki a ai. Yeah? That's how the tempo of the ute go.
And the reo matua is biblical. It's based on the words from the Bible. But sometimes we don't strictly the reo matua or the other compose on religious tune or that. We can bring like what we have tamatiki and tamarangi, bring all those things outside into. You know, if you eat, Josiah, you want salt, you want pepper, you want, you want all that. So that's what is happening today, yeah. But when it comes to the reo matua and the uapou, you use those words. But when you come to worshipping, you cannot put those in. You know, it's purely true religious tune. Like we sing, Yakumetaki Yehovah and all that. So we don't mix.
The reo matua is different. You have a tumu, and then the men will follow. So you have the women who does the tumu, meaning they start the song. And these are the women that carries the song. They know the song very well. They know how to harmonize themselves. And then you have two other piri. You have the piri tamo, which is a lower, see, like the soprano and alto, right? You have the soprano, which is the high pitch. And then you have the alto, which is the second layer of pitch, yeah, the softer pitch. So those are the three parts the women play, sing in the reo matua. So you have the women who's tumu and continue with the song, then you have these two that does the pitch, the high one and the lower. In the Cook Islands, I will rate the northern people as the men as the best piri. Because you know how the northern people sing in a high tune, eh? So men has also, if you listen to the reo matua of the northern people, men has a high part as well, and this is when the men come and does the piri. But today it has also applied to the southern group, because some of the northern people has lived in the southern islands, gone into the church or and continued with that practice. And now you'll be surprised how some young men can carry that pitch, because they have the voice and the volume to do that. You know, in the role that we play, one never taught by having an order of things on paper. One learns to become a composer by listening, by observing, and trying to do it yourself, by composing little poetries, little songs, learning and reading the scripture, because in the role of the Uapou, the reo mitua or the hymns are organized according to the scripture of that day. So whether, for example, if it's the psalm, like the one we're doing today, it comes from Psalm 67. So it talks about the praising of God. And this is the time, you know, the story of David, how he becomes who he is. So I tried to go into composing things by working into a group. And of course, I have a group of people that we sit down, we look at the script, and we try and organize. So these are the words that we're going to say, and then find a tune to go with it. A lot of times, you know how Cook Islands, we love to cut and paste. So wherever we go and where there's a reo mitua and there's a catchy tune, you hear. And it's sticking in your mind. So when you're sitting down to not realizing that you have copied someone else's tune, so you bring that tune into your hymn, and then you bring someone else's. So at the end of it, you have something. So you try and sing then to your friends, because they're the critic. They need to. Of course, with the reo mitua, you're going to have the ladies' part and you're going to have the women's part. So that's how I do it. I don't know how other people do it. That's how I do it.
I'm Joyce Daniels. I am the daughter of Pikirangi and Matariki Daniels, who have now passed on. He used to sing in the lounge, and he used to have his Bible, because he used to write songs. He'd write his songs from the Bible. And he'll just make them all. He was fantastic. You know, him and Mum would be sitting there and, you know, trying to work out the song, and then they'll put it together, and then they'll bring it to the church, and then they'll put it together. And he was so good at writing songs, and they all come from the Bible, and it was fabulous.
Compositions of songs is based on Bible verses. Reverend Timothy Tudu explains a composition of the 2013 Uapou's Tokoroa theme song.
So I'll compose the theme song, the Waine. It's all based on the thought. The thought of fear of the Uapou losing its taste. Because if we, Tokoroa, didn't take up the challenge this year, there may be a great doubt whether the Uapou will continue. So that's where the idea of the song and the ute came. You see, Baba Bill called us. So I based the thought. Even the theme is there. Go forward in the name of God. That is there. But using old words that will capture the idea. Perhaps people will say, they didn't base their thing on the theme. But it is the words that have been used brings out the words, the theme. Like Papa Kada's, you know, Josiah, when we started the ute, to'i to'i enuo ngariki, that lament. It is a lament. It's not a pity. It is a lament. It's a cry. It goes back to the story of Tautu. When Tautu was pushed by Waipai to the island, to the Motu, and then an old lady of Tautu cried out, and the words were hers. She was calling to Arutanga, to Tamato Ariki, and to Te Paki to help them. Toitoi means uprooting, uprooting. And Tautu was uprooted and pushed away by the Waipai people to the Motu. So Waipai came and took all the food and took over the land, the village and all that. So one lady, I forgot the name, I got the name but I forgot it, and she cried out. And her cry was heard in Arutanga. And Te Paki came and brought the people back. So basing the cry of Kades for the Uapou to continue, I opened our ute with that voice, the cry, because the Uapou may be uprooted and then die. That was the fear. So I started our Uapou to it. You know, that is why I started there. And then based on Papa Williamu, as a cry, and then following our ute, it is all celebration. Start with the cry, then forget about the cry, and now celebration. And the theme song is based on Vaini, you know, it's based on Tokoroa. Based on Tokoroa, because he looked up to Tokoroa to me. And we're just saying, hey, I'm here. Te Vaini, you know, Tokoroa, the tomb of the inward cannot be moved. We are strong in culture, and we are here to help you and hold on to
Tō mātou atu e mene, I te amataiti ko te atamaiti ko nei, ko te aratoa, Aaron Mutua, pōkarakara mai.
As the Uapou moves into its 40th year in 2015 and our elderly moving on, what and how will the future of the traditional way change?
My only fear is that the culture is moving into contemporary. The young composers of today is could be only speaking English, but could understand Cook Island language very well, but are unable to hold a conversation or deeper than that, because you know, culture is not a stable thing. Culture moves. So to be able to maintain the sustainability, it's the continuity and carrying on what they know from who they learn it from, where they learn it from, to continue with that. So you will find that we are dancing the same moves that our grandmothers have been dancing, but the tune of our songs, the words may be Cook Island, but the tune comes from the top hit at the media today. You know, some singers' song been used, the tune been used to highlight our culture, our. So can you see that happening with the merging of cultures? Yeah. Taking one from the Western and taking the one from our tradition and marrying together. To be able to move together so that the young people of today, you know, love these type of songs. So you put it into a Cook Island wording and you dance to it and then take it away. So that's the way the Uapou will move now. We still maintain our old ways of doing things, but that our younger, upcoming composers and dancer will take it to the next level.
Culture is in the constant change, and the Uapou has been a great vehicle to maintain the Cook Islands culture. What will the future of the Uapou look like?
But when, and I say, when we die, who among you people who would sustain it, who would carry on? You may carry on, but what about after you?
The future of the Uapou lies in the hands of developing young leaders who have the passion and desire to carry on this great idea, first introduced by Papa Toru Binion back in 1975.
We need new blood in, new younger people, right? Which they can communicate with our young people. Very important.
Recognizing those that are, that God's bringing out with great leadership skills that can actually take on the Uapou, maybe not even over 40 years to come, but centuries to come.
Uapou